Six new shows premiered in syndication on Monday, although only two of them, Page Six TV and Daily Mail TV, are nationally cleared. The rest of them either are only airing in select markets or don't plan to receive national Nielsen ratings. Premier Day ratings are metered market only, with six markets in Florida not reporting due to the ongoing effects of Hurricane Irma. 20th Television's Page Six TV, produced by Endemol Shah North America, and based on the New York Post's famous gossip section, opened in 48 metered markets on Monday with a 0.8 RATING 2 share primary on household average. That's the highest opening day rating of any Access magazine launch since Warner Bros. TMZ in 2007. That said, not very many magazines have debuted in recent years. Trifecta's OK TV, now Celebrity Page, premiered in 2013 and averages a 0.3 household rating, while 20th's Dish Nation, featuring radio DJ teams from around the country, started in 2012 and is currently averaging a 0.7 in households. Related, Jesse Palmer's Ready to Go Fast and Furious is host of Daily Mail this year. However, there are three, with Tegna's Daily Blast Live joining Page Six TV and Daily Mail TV. In daytime's key demographic of women 25-54, Page Six TV averaged a 0.54. The show was number 1 in its time slot in 4 of 22 local People Meter markets. Page Six TV's strongest market was Baltimore, Maryland, where it did a 3.512 at 12:30 p.m. on Hearstown CBS affiliate WBAL, up 59% from its year-ago time period average. Related, for stations, local color will be in season this fall. Daily Mail TV, based on the British publication and popular website, opened with 46 metered markets reporting and scored a 0.72 primary or unweighted metered market average and a 0.32 among women 25-54. The show did best in St. Louis, Mo, where it clocked a 2.37 on Tribune and KTVI at noon and was up 35% over last year. Daily Blast Live premiered in 19 metered markets, with overall clearances in 36 tagged markets, averaging a 0.83 with a 0.32 in the key demo. Related, daytime experiment looks to be a blast. Show's best performance came in Buffalo, where it turned in a 4.37 on WGRZ at 7:30 p.m., up 39% from last year at this time. Daily Blast Live had been scheduled to premiere on September 11th. But it was delayed a week in order to allow Tegna's Houston station, KU, use of the show's control room as a result of flooding from Hurricane Harvey. MGM's Couples Court with the Cutlers, airing in 45 metered markets, opened at a 0.62 in households for all telecasts. The show did best in Washington, D.C., at noon on WDCW, where it earned a 1.56, up 7% from year ago. Related, Couples crosses Court with Talk for New Genre. Several shows also debuted that are not cleared nationally, including Daily Blast Live. Scripps' new talk show, Pickler Ben, starring Kelly Pickler and Ben Aaron, bowed in 17 metered markets at a 1.44 with a 0.54 in the key demo. The show did best in its home market of Nashville on WTVF at 9 a.m., where it did a 6.820, up 58% from what CTD's Rachel Rate did in the time period last year. Picker and Ben also is airing on Viacom CMT. Related, CMT picks up Pickler Ben. Tegna Sister Circle, debuting in 8 metered markets, came in at a 0.62 in households and a 0.42 in the demo. That show did best in Norfolk, Virginia, on WVEC at 1 a.m., where it averaged a 1.75, up 70% from its year-ago time period average.